You're here, we're here, but for how much longer? Events of the last couple of weeks have made it clear New Zealand's media sector is in crisis, with Newshub set to shut its doors and TVNZ proposing to axe 4 news and current affairs programs. Media and Communications Minister Melissa Lee says she's working on a bill to improve the sector and joins us now. Morena Minister, 250-odd jobs on the line. Has the latest news from TVNZ changed your plans for the future of New Zealand's media industry?
Can I first of all start by acknowledging the current situation with you and everyone at TVNZ? This is not something that everyone actually wants to see or face, but my thoughts are with everyone as they work through the restructure. In terms of my plan, well, before becoming a politician, I worked as a journalist. I became a journalist because I believed in the importance of journalism. And I continue to believe in the importance of journalism to our democracy. Since opposition, I have been active in working with the media sector to understand the issues. We all know that recent events in the media that seem to come up in the last couple of weeks, it's not just happened all of a sudden, it's been coming for some time. Audiences have moved to different platforms.
We all understand the situation, I think, no more so than probably our audience who watch us quite religiously, and for that we are very grateful. But you talk about the situation at the moment, and I'm wondering if that has changed your plans for what hoping to do.
As I was actually trying to lay down, you know, once I became government, which is 3 months ago, I have been working with my officials to understand, actually bring the concerns from the sector to have a discussion with my official, to work with me to understand what the levers the government can actually pull to help the sector. And, you know, some levers actually need legislation or changes in the regulatory setting. I will be taking my plan to cabinet. I cannot actually talk specifics about the plan, but what I can say is that my plan includes modernizing the Broadcasting Act of 1989, which was, you know, so long ago before modern technology actually happened, looking at better harnessing technology and innovation as the sector continues to transition online, and also ensuring that the government's investment in media actually remains well set up to deliver independent and trusted sources of news and information. I will be able to share a little bit more once I've actually been through the cabinet process. I know it's frustrating, but I've actually said this before last week as well.
Would that include the possibility that TV1 or both channels on TVNZ become linear channels commercial free?
I cannot actually talk about any details because it hasn't actually been through cabinet process.
Would you consider that to be one of the options, though? You personally, would that be an option that you would consider?
Well, I think we are working through many options as to what could potentially help the sector rather than specifically TVNZ.
Okay, so you're looking at broader things like that then. It's not just TVNZ that's the focus of this.
Well, you know, 2 weeks ago there was Warner Brothers Discovery. You know, last week it was TVNZ. The sector is in crisis, but it has been coming for a few years. And you know, one of the frustrating things that I find is that the previous government is six years to actually fix this. It was coming for a long time.
But has it been because last year, Tracy Martin has just told Media Watch that TVNZ painted, quote, a very rosy picture of its future revenue only 2 years ago. So it hasn't, that's not the story that TVNZ's been telling the government.
Well, Tracy Martin was the chairperson and the lead for trying to merge TVNZ and Radio New Zealand.
Job losses, though.
That Warner Brothers Discovery could have potentially collapsed much earlier than, the transition at the moment.
What was your understanding when TVNZ contacted you last week with this news about the details of what was to be announced about the job losses?
The TVNZ did not, last week, okay, let's actually go back. I had a meeting when the half-year financials actually came through, and I met with the TVNZ leadership. and to talk about the financials, but it was a wide-ranging conversation about, you know, broader media sector, as well as Warner Brothers Discovery's news.
Did you expect a heads up?
Sorry?
Did you expect a heads up on job losses?
Well, I think they did actually tell me when we were talking about the financials that they will have to restructure, and they were potentially having to look at, you know, some job cuts. I wasn't expecting it to be announced the following week.
What questions did you ask about the job losses?
I was actually doing an interview with Newstalk ZB when Heather Duplessis-Ellen actually said, what's being announced tomorrow? And I had absolutely no idea. What happened was that I was in an interview and I had no, I hadn't had an alert in terms of the heads up, the no surprises. And it did actually come through.
Can I ask you, should New Zealanders expect to have access to free-to-air news and maybe some current affairs?
I would hope so.
And in terms of free-to-air, what does that look like to you? TVNZ has a statement of intent that refers to our content being readily accessible. Presumably that means to all Kiwis. So would that include free-to-air television?
Well, ready accessibility would actually mean that it is free, right? Or,
yes,
you know, it could be behind a paywall, but it is available because they have connectivity.
Well, a paywall would imply you have to pay for it, so that wouldn't be readily accessible for all New Zealanders.
For majority, yes. But, yeah, no, free-to-air is something that I actually support.
So is there a case then for TVNZ to have some sort of structure where it is non-commercial then, to be able to allow it, under its statement of intent, to provide that service to all of New Zealanders, that New Zealanders can have an expectation they will always be able to get some news that isn't behind a paywall?
Well, it is currently so, and TVNZ's model is that it actually relies on advertising revenue to actually make their productions available. And also, government has actually supported content broadcasting as well as other media through New Zealand On Air, you know, and I think it's to the tune of around $300 million a year through New Zealand On Air for Kata Māori and Te Maunga Pāho. And I think, you know, these are the mechanisms that the government actually has. In terms of the TVNZ operation, it is up to TVNZ to decide how they actually run their operations. It is not something that a minister or any government should actually get into in terms of how they actually gather news or how they actually make programs or how they program their channels.
I want to ask you about that in just a moment. The shows that TVNZ is proposing to cut, two of them, Sunday and Fairgo, are profitable. The staff have been told that they are profitable. Do you agree in principle with the decision to cancel positive yield shows?
Look, it is the decision to cut any program is not something that I have any control over. It is actually purely a TVNZ decision.
I understand. Yeah, I understand you don't have control. I'm just asking, if it's making money, do you think it's a good idea to cut it?
Well, that is for TVNZ to decide.
Do you have an opinion on it?
I can actually say that I do actually like those programs, but I have no control over what TVNZ does, and that is purely a decision for TVNZ management, TVNZ board.
When we hear from the government, though, and from other ministers, that they are looking at whether we return a profit and whether we are equitable, surely it would make sense to keep shows that do actually make money for the station.
That is, as I said, that is a decision for TVNZ board and TVNZ management to actually make.
David Seymour, comments you made last week, and you, off the back of them, said, I think it is my responsibility as Minister of Broadcasting to have a conversation with him, so I will. Have you had that conversation with him?
Well, I think the context was David apparently said something and I hadn't actually seen it. And would I actually talk to David to remind him about his responsibility as a shareholding minister? It is not my job to actually sort of have a you know, conversation about it. But I had a sort of a casual conversation with David, I think, on the weekend, and just reminded him. And he said, yes, he knows his responsibilities. And that was, you know, the end of the conversation, really.
Can you expand a little bit about what your comment was to him about his responsibilities? You've told us what he replied. What did you say to him?
Well, I just told him, I said, I just wanted to have a conversation about, you know, shareholders' responsibilities. I think the conversation between me and David is our own, right? I mean, David has his views and I have mine. I'm not going to be commenting on David's comments. And, you know, I'm focused on my plans for the future of media. And I think, you know, I'm here to talk to you about that.
All the best with those plans. Media and Communications Minister Melissa Lee joining us this morning.
Thank you.